let's do the obvious one first. For this one right here, let me just say that u equal to tangent x. How come? Because I know right away, when I differentiate this, I get the derivative of tangent x, which is secant squared x dx, right? And you see, I can take this integral into the u world right away. This is the integral. Tangent x is my u, right? This is my u right here. And secant squared x times dx, that's my du. So we are just integrating u in the u world right away. Of course, this is u to the first power. You add 1 to the power and divide it by the new power. So we get 1 half u squared. U is tangent x. So just put that down right here. So finally, we have 1 half tangent squared x. And we are done. So put down plus c like this. This is the first result that we can have for that integral. And now, let's check this out. Remember, this is the integral of tangent x times secant squared x. So technically, we have two functions, namely tangent x and also secant x, right? Is it possible for us to let u equal to secant x? Well, in this case, yes. But we have to just do it carefully, because you have to know the derivative of secant x is what? Tangent x times secant x, right? So now, this is how I would do it right here. I'm going to first look at this integral as the following. I will look at this as the integral. Let me break the secant squared x apart as following. Let me write it down as secant x first. And then we still have this tangent x, right? Let me just put that down. And then times another secant x. This secant x times this secant x, we get the secant squared x. And then let me put down the dx right here. All right? And now I'm going to let u equal to this secant x, because now you see du will be secant x tangent x dx, isn't it? And you will see this is equal to the integral. The secant x, it's the u, right? It's this u right here, that's the secant x. And tangent x secant x dx, this right here, is my du. So I'm just integrating u in the u world as well. Do this right here, we get 1 half u squared, right? In this case, u is secant x. So our result here is 1 half secant squared x. We are done. We can also put down plus c like this. OK, now you may be wondering. This is the answer that we got earlier involving tangent. This is the result that we got right now, involving secant. Which one is actually correct? Well, maybe they are both correct. Well, maybe we did something wrong. Well, in this case, they are actually both correct, but they look different because of the constant c. So what we should be doing is that this right here should be c1, and this right here should be c2. The result of the integration could be off by a constant, all right? Once again, the result of the integration could be off by a constant. So if you do it this way, so you get a constant c1. Maybe your friend did it this way. Well, they have another constant. You have to label them as c1 and c2. And now, here is the explanation why they are actually correct. So this is the idea of off by a constant. Let me just put this is equal to that first for you guys. So this is kind of like my check. On the left-hand side, let me put down 1 half tangent squared x plus c1. And then on the right-hand side, let me put down 1 half secant squared x plus c2. And you will see, let me just go ahead multiply everything by 2, because we don't like fractions, OK? Let's multiply everything by 2. Hopefully, you guys don't mind this at all. And you will have 1 half times 2, which is just 1, so that's tangent squared x, 2 times c1, right, plus 2c1, this is equal to this times that, which is just 1. We have secant squared x, 2 times c2, right, so plus c2 like this. And now, this is what I would like to do. Let me subtract 2c2 on both sides. Ooh, right here, 2 times c2 right here, sorry. Anyway, let's do it again. Let me minus 2c2 on both sides, so I'll put down minus 2c1 right here, right? OK, so this right here is out. On the left-hand side, I have tangent square x. On the right-hand side, we have secant square x. And this right here is just a constant, it's just a number. This right here, let me write it down all in blue. Why not? Plus 2c2 minus 2c1, all right? Remember, c1 is a number, c2 is also a number, and just to be fancier, we can say they're constants, all right? So c1 is a constant. If you have minus c2, this is still a constant. This is the constant, times 2 is a constant. Constant minus another constant, altogether is the constant. And you may be wondering, what in the world is that constant? Do you guys recognize what this value should be? Well, we know, right? This is the famous identity that you guys should know as well. We know that tangent square x, this has to be equal to secant square x, and then what? Minus 1. This is an identity. Well, now, this match, so what is this? This and that has to be the same, isn't it? So in other words, 2c2 minus 2c1 is nothing but just negative 1. Alright, so this is the idea. We may get different looking results, but they are just off by a constant. If you differentiate this, you will get that for the answer, for the original. If you differentiate that, you also get that for the derivative. So they are both the antiderivative of the integrand. Anyway, that's it. All right?